My name is Alberto. I'm a PhD student. Before starting, I would like to thank the organizing and the scientific committee at EMPODER for allowing me to present this communication, which is titled "Prevention, Assessment, Diagnosis, and Management of Diabetic Food Based on Clinical Practice Guidelines." Diabetes is a pathology. As we know, it affects 2 million people worldwide, and the global prevalence has increased rapidly in the last 30 years, and the trend is expected to continue increasing in the future from the current 5.1% to 7.7% in 2020. Sorry, in 2030. And the clinical practice guidelines are recommendations based on evidence from systematic reviews and the risk and benefits evaluation of the different alternatives, with the aim to optimizing the healthcare. The main aim of this study was to carry out a systematic review of the levels of evaluation and treatment strategies that appear in the clinical practice guidelines focused on diabetic foods or diabetes with diabetic food sections. And another aim of this study was to perform an analysis of the levels of evidence in support of the recommendation made by the selected clinical practice guidelines. The review was registered according to the protocol PROSPERO, and it was conducted in accordance with PRISMA rules. And the databases consulted were PubMed, NICE, SINA, Scopus, Helgain, ERAN-AO, SAIN, and NCG. And the search term used were diabetic foods guidelines, practice guidelines, and diabetes. Here we have the flow diagram showing the result obtained. In the search, in the document included after applying inclusion and exclusion criteria and the quality evaluation with the agreed to score. For the inclusion criteria, it was followed with a PICO method, and for exclusion criteria, the CPGs whose title and summary did not match with the current review were excluded. And CPEs that did not classify levels of evidence or grade of recommendation were excluded, and all the CPEs previous that the last version were excluded. About the quality assessment, to blend the researches, assessing the quality of the selected CPEs by the agreed to evaluation. And here we have the result of the agreed to. About the grading of evidence, to evaluate the CPGs based on evidence, we have evaluated the levels of evidence according to letters and the grade of recommendation according to colors. So the best topic is the level of evidence A and the grade of recommendation green, and the worst is the level of evidence D and the grade in color red. And in case of controversy within the CPG, it was notified. Here we have the result in the table. Here we have the CPGs. And here we have the topics divided into evaluation and treatment. So the ERAN-AO white showed a superior quality than the rest of the CPGs. About the discussions, the evaluation of the CPG provides a summary of the levels of evidence and the grade of recommendation useful for diagnosis, assessing, and the treatment of the diabetic foods according to the result provided by the CPGs selected. After analyzing the result, it was observed a lack of consistency regarding the level of evidence and the grade of recommendation in most of the guidelines included. And in summary, we can say that the highly recommendable intervention for diabetic food management are the treatment with a very high level of evidence and strongly recommended. Food evaluation and therapeutic food work are a very good two topic. So in conclusion, as well as a summary, the heterogeneity of the results make it very difficult to interpret and assume them in the clinical practice. And CPGs must be constantly updated to not become obsolete and collect the latest advances in the different health areas. And despite this, and according to the detailed study of the guidelines included in this article, it can be concluded that the highly recommendable intervention for diabetic food management are the treatment, as I said before. So here we have the original article, so people who are interested in the full article, I made to you to read the article in PubMed, and this is for free in open access versions. Thank you so much for your visit, and I hope that this presentation was to your liking.